Hey guys, today we have both the 350 Zs here, and they're both 2006 models, and we're going to show you a particular brake mod that you can do to improve brake pedal feel and performance. So for me, you guys know that I am way more concerned with driver feel and how you interact with the vehicle before you start putting money into making the car faster or looks or any of that. It's all about driver feel is the first thing you should be focusing on. And the problem I always had with my car was when I would brake, it would brake really well, but the pedal always felt kind of mushy, not horrible, but kind of mushy. Like my 05 Silverado felt great, but I did the exact same thing, you know, new brake fluid, stainless steel braided lines, you know, everything's pretty fresh in the car, but this car towards the threshold would just get spongy compared to my other vehicles, and I just couldn't pinpoint why. I'd sit in a lot of other vehicles and they would feel great, and this particular, for being a sports car, it doesn't feel as good as it should. And you know, I was actually on z1motorsports.com just looking for stuff for my car, and I came across a particular mod and it made so much sense. And in the description it even says to look at your brake booster when you're applying, when you're doing a brake application, because the firewall in these cars is actually thin and the booster moves. So I have Trevor in the car right now, and I actually cut this wire so hopefully you have a point of reference, because it's kind of hard to see it, but I want to get him to do several hard brake applications, and you're actually going to see the booster or the master cylinder on the booster move a little bit. Okay, Trevor, hit the brake. Let go. Hit the brake. Let go. You can see over here, it's actually pushing up on the siren, moving it. Okay. Trevor, hit the brake again. Let go. And one more time. Let go. So I'm not sure if you guys can see it on camera, but it is moving ever so slightly. And in my books, a component like this, no matter how big or strong you are, you should not be able to move it. So I'm going to show you a little accessory that's easy to install that's going to correct this. So now we're going to do several brake applications on this unit and see if there's any kind of movement or deflection. So go ahead and make a brake application. Release. Another brake application. Release. One more big one. Release. Obviously it's not going to move because of all the bracketry we have, and we have that improved pedal feel like we discussed before. So here we are in my car, and what it actually you do is you put in a bracket. This is all CNC machined, and there's a bracket here with a bolt and a jam nut, and it loads right up against the booster. So when you're installing it, you tighten it all the way so it's actually you're already pushing up against it, and that way this thing can't move at all. You see here there's a bracket. Now it loads up onto the factory strut. So these special fasteners right here, these bolts, well, you take out the factory ones and then you put this onto it. So this will actually hold in the factory dampener down there. And then you have this whole brace. So the load coming off the bolt goes into this other bracket, which holds the reservoir for the clutch, and then attaches to this, you know, dummy firewall, and it bolts to the other bracket and it loads the force right into this piece, because this is on your suspension, like a critical point of your suspension, and all this area is incredibly strong. This wall is not that strong, so that's why they had to load it into here. So the load is coming off the brake booster from your foot all the way in and down, and this corrects that whole issue. And what I noticed immediately was a much better brake feel. Now it's not perfect, it doesn't make it super tight. It's dependent on your calipers and the actual pedal itself, but what I did notice was right off the bat, my brake application just felt a lot better. And for a lot of you guys that do autocross or any kind of racing, pedal feels extremely important. So doing this mod alone, it's like, it's under $200 to buy this piece. It's worth doing. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Instagram and Facebook, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca. We'll be right back.